My alarm goes off at 5:20. Get up, go work out. It could be track, could be in the pool, could be lifting weights, could be just shooting, anything like this. Get that morning workout in from 7:58 to 3:05. I have my classwork. Then after school, I'll either go play some pickup with just guys around town or go do my own little individual workout. Then after that, I come home and study for 2 to 3 hours.
I would say that I probably see Harrison 2 hours a day. He comes in, he eats with us, and then he is studying after that. And then I see him at the end of the night.
And then get ready for the next morning.
By practicing every day with the shot, practicing every day with his ball handling, he's been able to turn the potential into a success and eventually into, number one recruit in the country.
Mid-November featured two huge events at Ames High. First was the press conference the sporting world had been waiting for.
Good afternoon, everyone. We're breaking into programming to bring you a big sports announcement.
Ames High School senior and basketball standout Harrison Barnes is just moments away from announcing where he's going to attend college and play basketball.
Today, I am proud to announce that the school I will attend in the fall of 2010 will be the coach that I'm going to scout.
Coach Roy Williams.
I just want to let you know that I'll be joining you guys next year on the squad. I can't wait to play with all you guys.
All right!
Let's go. Journey starts again, all in. All in.
3 days later, the Little Cyclones hit the floor for the first team practice of the season.
Get out and go! It's a beautiful day. We're back in the hunt. There's no need for that ball to hit the ground. There you go. That's transition. Nice job. Next crew. Come on, work it. Work it. Beat it. No, come on. Bring it back, Eric. Good job.
Last year, it was March 14th, state championship game. That was the most fun I've ever had in a game, in a basketball game in my life. And I just hope we can continue to work every day and get back to that place.
The first game as defending champions came a little more than 2 weeks later.
Stay the course, stay together, do what we do. All right, first step of the journey. Let's go, let's go.
When Ames took on Urbandale at the Knapp Center in Des Moines.
15, 1, 2, 3.
That first step was more like a leap. Little Cyclones rolled over Urbandale with Harrison and his teammates putting on a show.
I'm just really anxious to see where the season goes. I think we have a lot of great guys, and I just can't wait to play with these guys.
These guys are a talented veteran group. Starting alongside Barnes, our senior guard Riley Stuvey.
It's pretty tough to describe. Like, it's a lot of fun, and I mean, it's even more fun because, like, most of us are like all seniors and we've been playing together for a long time, and so it's just really fun.
Senior guard Michael Weber.
He's just nonstop. He's, you know, I have no reservations about playing him 4 quarters a night, every night, 32 minutes, and he's just fun.
Mike's probably my best friend here in Ames. I mean, he's a really funny kid, and he is shy around school and stuff like that, but on the court, he's a really good point guard, and he just distributes, and he really communicates with us.
Senior forward Doug McDermott.
Yeah, I think there's always pressure. I mean, after winning last year, winning the state title, we're going to get a packed house everywhere we go.
And senior forward James Kohler.
You know, I think we're really blessed, the group of seniors we have now that were on the team last year. I think a big part of our success has been, I mean, Coach Downs preaching every day about win today. We got to come back to practice, come back to each game every night, and make sure we give maximum effort every day.
Now remember, H, try not to come off both the same side. Snake it.
You know, I certainly realize that we're very fortunate, and I'm very fortunate as a coach to have this group of kids for a number of reasons, not just because they're terrific basketball players. When it's all said and done, I think I'll look back and realize what a neat ride it's been.
With winning comes higher expectations and more national exposure. Up next, the Little Cyclones battle an out-of-state foe on national TV and a potential state tournament preview on the floor where the Little Cyclones won it all 1 year ago.